Risk management in itself is a strategy, and an important one in fact. It contributes greatly to your success in trading, and I'm going to show you how you can properly manage your risk like most other professional traders out there. The important concepts that we are going to cover today include capital preservation and how to determine your risk to reward for your trades. So make sure to watch till the end and show your support by dropping a like and subscribe to the channel. When we talk about trading, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? Am I right to say trading strategy? When we hear people talk about trading, it's often, hey, what strategy are you using? Or what's your win rate? In other words, how much do you win? Or what's your reward like? Seldom do you hear people ask, what's your risk management strategy? Or what's your risk to reward like? Notice the drastic difference in the terms that are used here. Win rate in the first case versus risk to reward in the second case. There are millions of creative and interesting trading strategies out there. But do you realize that a trading strategy only tells you when to buy? A risk management strategy tells you how much to buy, when to sell, how much do you win or how much do you lose when you execute a trade. Therefore, can you see that it is actually risk management that is more important here? In fact, I would say that 60% of your success in trading lies in having a good risk management system, and only 20% comes from your strategy. The remaining 20% goes to your own psychology, emotional management, as well as a little bit of luck. So the first lesson on risk management is to properly preserve your capital. As a trader, trading is your business, and your capital is the life of your business. Therefore, in order to be successful in trading, you need to do whatever you can to protect and preserve your capital. What's worse is that losses work against you. If you lose 10% of your capital, how much do you need to make in order to get back to break even? It's not 10%, alright, but it's 11%. If you can't see this relationship, let me draw you a simple example. Let's say we started off with $1,000, and then we lost 10% of it, which is $100. And with that, we are left with $900. Now, in order to break even, how much do you need to earn now? Still $100, but the catch is this. You need to earn back this $100 with only $900 worth of capital. And that in itself is an 11% gain of your remaining capital. Now, do not think that this is not a big deal, because this asymmetrical lose-win relationship gets worse the more you lose. If you lose 20% of your capital, what you need next is a 25% gain in order to break even. And if you get to the point of an 80% loss, you need to quadruple your account only to break even. Sounds easy? If you can quadruple your account with ease, you would not have lost 80% in the first place. Therefore, always treat your capital as your life and preserve it. So then, naturally comes the next question. What can we do to preserve our capital? Before you enter a trade, always ask yourself, if this trade turns bad, how much am I going to lose? And if you're thinking in terms of a flat dollar amount, please change this bad mindset and think in terms of percentage instead. And this percentage represents the percentage of your capital. So maybe before you enter this trade, you set a rule saying that you are only going to lose 1% of your capital at max from this trade. Once you have this rule set in place, then can you enter the trade. And once in the trade, no matter what happens, you are not to shift your stop loss down such that you will take a loss of more than 1% of your capital. So in this case, your risk level is 1%. And it is even better if you can apply the same risk level to all your trades, so that all trades have an equal weightage and impact on your portfolio, whether you win or you lose. Alright, risk level set. 1x. When we trade, our ultimate goal is to be profitable. No one trades to lose, right? So the next step will be to set a favorable and reasonable reward for your trade. Personally, for my trading style, I like to have a reward to risk ratio of at least 2. That means to say that when I win 2% of my capital, and when I lose, I only lose 1% of my capital. And likewise, if I were to risk 2% of my capital, I will ensure that the trade will make me 4% if I win. So it is up to you to set your reward level, but keep in mind two important criteria. And that is, your reward level must be favorable. In other words, when you win, you must win more than you lose. The second criteria is that your reward level must be reasonable. Let me illustrate this with an example. For example, you see this nice, beautiful trade, and you see that this stock has been testing the trend line for 3 times now. And when it comes back down to test the trend line for the 4th time, you yourself are ready to enter the trade. So following your strategy, let's say that you will be entering at $51.75 with a stop loss of $49. This means that for this trade, your one unit of risk is at $2.75. So following our predefined risk to reward, if we are risking one to make one, which we should not do so by the way, our profit target will be at $54.50. And if our reward to risk ratio is 2, meaning to say we are risking 1 to make 2, our profit target will then be at $57.25. And likewise, if we are risking 1 to make 3, the profit target will be at $60. And you can see this intermediate level at $55.88, that represents a reward to risk ratio of 1.5. And as the trade progresses, you see that with a reward to risk ratio of 1, 1.5, and 2, we would have exited the trade with a profit, and this would be a winning trade for us. For a reward to risk ratio of 3, we have to let the trade run a bit longer. But unfortunately, the impulsive wave could not sustain, and the trade hit our stop loss first. Resulted in a loss if you have set your reward to risk ratio of this trade being at 3. And this is what I meant by having a reasonable reward to risk ratio. I am not saying that you cannot have a reward to risk of 3 or higher, but just know that the greedier you are, the lower the win rate of your trades. And when you combine all of these together, we are going to have something very powerful. With a reward to risk of 2, let's say we make 10 trades. And out of these 10 trades, we lose 6 of them and win only 4 of them. Not that fantastic, am I right? But the result is going to prove us wrong. From the 6 trades, if we risk 1% per trade, we lose 6% in total. And from the 4 winning trades, guess what? We are making 8%. And that leaves us with a net profit of 2%, even with a win rate of just 40%. In other words, with a risk to reward of 2, even with a lousy strategy that is only giving you 40% win rate, you can be profitable. And that is how important risk and reward management is. Suddenly you realize, hey, I do not need to be searching for that holy grail strategy that's giving me 80 or 90% win rate anymore. If I have a proper risk to reward management, even with a low win rate, I can ensure that I will be profitable most of the time. What I'm going to show you next is a simple simulation over 100 trades with different risk to reward levels and also different win rates. And you can see for yourself the importance of the concepts that we have covered today. This is a simple program that I've written myself. Basically, what it does is that it will generate 100 random trades with the stated probability of winning. So let's say 40%. And the percentage of capital that is being risk per trade and the reward level. So following previous example, we will be risking 1% to make 2% per trade. And so with a starting capital of $10,000, this program will calculate the outcome of 100 trades for us. So after keying in the parameters that we have been using for the previous example, I now click on simulate, and you can see for yourself the results that's being generated. With our risk parameters set in place over a sample of 100 trades, here are the results. We started off with 10,000 capital and we ended with 12,800. Then this gives us a return of 28.25% with an expectancy of 0.2825. So what the expectancy tells you is that in this set of 100 trades, where we even out the profits, you are actually making 0.2825% per trade. And then we have our drawdown, which I'll be explaining in a while. And lastly, in this sample of 100 trades, we actually have a win rate of 42%, meaning that out of our 100 trades, we win 42 and we lose 58. And on this graph over here, you can just see how your capital changes with each trade across a total of 100 trades. Likewise, if you change the win rate to now 50%, but with a reward to risk of only 1, meaning we risk 1% to make 1%. And you can see the results if I were to generate this simulation multiple times. So if we just focus on the capital plot over here, you can see that this red dotted line signifies our starting capital. And if you see that the lines go under it, this means that at the end of 100 trades, we have a loss. And for the opposite, if the lines ended up above the red dotted line, meaning that we have a profit after the end of 100 trades. When your system does not provide you with a statistical edge, you can see that it is almost akin to gambling, with equal win and equal loss on both sides. But once you have the edge and appropriate risk management system set in place, trading becomes a business. Even with a reward to risk ratio of 1.5, and at 50% win rate, you can see how profitable it can be. And if I were to simulate this multiple times, you can see that across all samples of our 100 trades, we're almost 90% profitable. You can see that only in one instance of a sample of 100 trades that we end up at a loss. Alright, but that doesn't mean that now you go ahead and set some crazy risk level, alright? As you increase your risk level, you notice that your max drawdown starts to increase. Alright, if you didn't take note of this, rewind back to the previous examples and compare the maximum drawdown in the previous examples as to what we have seen now. If I were to set a crazy risk level of 10% and a reward level of 15%, which give us a reward to risk ratio of 1.5. What drawdown basically means is that it is the percentage drop of your capital from the highest amount achieved at the point in time. And the max drawdown just means that the highest percentage of drawdown that you experience over the course of these 100 trades. And you can see that if we set crazy risk level, like risking 10% of your capital per trade, we will now have to be able to endure a maximum drawdown of 40% over. And this occurs at the trade of around 30 plus. So let us go down to that region and you can see for yourself. So at this point, at trade number 19, you have a capital of 20,000. And as you go on a loose streak, you can see that your capital starts to drop, and at worst, you suffer an almost 41% drop from the peak of your capital of 20,000. So can you do that emotionlessly and not be psychologically affected? Most people can't. When they see their account drop just 20% or even 10%, not to say that this is a 40% drop in this case, they go crazy and their emotions will start to interfere with their trades and prevent themselves from making good trades. And that is where your win rate will get screwed up and then decrease drastically from there on. So no matter what risk to reward you are going to set for your trading system, always be mentally prepared for losing streaks. Psychologically, you must be able to take drawdowns of 10% with ease without your emotions getting into your way of executing each trade perfectly. And you can see that with our previous example of 40% win rate and risk to reward of 1:2, can you see that even with such a low risk level here, you have to endure a drawdown of 6% of your highest capital achieved. And the more you risk per trade, the higher your potential maximum drawdown will be. Personally, I do not recommend to go beyond a risk level of 3% per trade. And if you are new, always paper trade first and stick to just 1% or even 0.5% per trade. And if you are testing out a new strategy, also paper trade over a large sample of trades so that you can properly estimate the win rate that the strategy is able to give you. With that, I hope that you have learned some important risk management strategy today. And I hope that this skill will stay with you throughout your trading journey. What we have covered in this video is more of how to limit your losses, to preserve your capital, and set your profit target. In the second part of the risk management strategy video, we will be going through the next important question, and that is how much to buy. We will be dealing with concepts of position sizing and more. As always, do remember to drop a like and subscribe so that we could reach a wider audience and benefit all from growing their wealth in the market safely. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.